Hello and welcome to the Banker's Tech Talk video series, looking at all things fintech. We've been going now for about 6 years, and you can watch all previous episodes on thebanker.com/techtalks. I'm Joy Macknight, editor of The Banker. And with me this week is Amber Ghaddar, who's founder of AllianceBlock, a globally compliant decentralized capital market. Amber, thanks so much for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
So how are blockchain and artificial intelligence technology disintermediating the exchange of value?
I think first, let's take a step back and look at the third industrial revolution, which was the internet and mobile communication, which disintermediated the flow of information and democratized the access to knowledge. Now, fast forward a quarter of a century, today we have blockchain, AI, and other emerging tech that are here to disintermediate the exchange of value by democratizing the access to capital, and even democratizing capitalism itself. So how are we doing this? First, by disintermediating the current financial system, meaning you collapse the pyramid of interaction within the system. Second, by automatizing most of the transaction flows and most of the processes, operational process in the system. And then third, by creating even new products that didn't exist before in the decentralized space. One thing we need to be aware of is that new technologies have undeniably shifted our financial industry from a socio-technical system that is controlled by social relations into a techno-social system that is controlled by autonomous technical mechanism. So how does this affect capitalism in a way, and why is it very important to think about the democratization of capitalism in this day and age? It's because the fourth industrial revolution, especially automation and AI, is going to create a huge unemployment in our modern societies, in our first world societies. And trust me, no governments are thinking about how to manage this massive future unemployment. One solution that we believe could help is actually giving access to the bottom 50% of the population to capitalism, allowing them to invest their capital to generate more capital and allow them to have a sustainable lifestyle just based on their capital. In the current model, in traditional finance, the rate of returns is very small. So if you invest £1,000 or £2,000, you cannot make a living in equity markets. But in decentralized finance space, the type of products that we have that can yield between 50% to, well, sometimes 1,000%, is a model that is sustainable to allow people in the bottom 50% of the population to live in dignity once automation hit our economy.
So let's dive a little bit deeper into that. What is the difference between DeFi and TradFi?
Yes, so TradFi or traditional finance is the legacy banking system. DeFi stands for decentralized finance, and it's actually an umbrella term that includes financial applications that are built on various blockchains. These financial applications can replicate current financial products like borrowing and lending, insurance, but they can also create new products that do not exist in the current financial ecosystem. Products like decentralized exchanges, liquidity pool, staking, etc., etc. And between you and me, it was the rise of decentralized exchanges last summer that actually created or has been driven the DeFi boom since 2020.
So how would you say that AllianceBlock is bridging that gap between DeFi and TradFi?
So in layman terms, AllianceBlock is a protocol that sits on top of various blockchain, but also that sits on top of traditional banking infrastructure. The issue that TradFi has, our financial institution have into accessing DeFi, is an infrastructure problem, but also a regulatory problem. In terms of infrastructure, blockchain will require these financial institutions to build a new operational system, new infrastructure that, between you and me, is very complicated, very costly, and sometimes banks don't have the time to create a new operation, new IT team to access this product. So what we offer them is an infrastructure that smells, tastes, and looks the same as their traditional operational infrastructure. And then the second point is regulation and compliance. DeFi space, in a way, is very much unregulated yet. And financial institutions that are regulated by regulators are obliged to abide by certain regulations and certain rules. So we have created what we call a trustless KYC AML framework and also a cross-border regulatory compliance framework that sort of clean up all of this DeFi project and highlight those that are available, that are regulatory compliant, to allow these traditional financial institutions to dig in the high, very high yielding space that we have in DeFi. A good example is on the US dollar, right? I mean, Fed rates today are what, 25 basis points? 10-year treasury are trading at 1.60%, while if you deposit some of your USD stablecoin into a staking program in the decentralized finance space, you can get up to 12% per annum. So for a lot of private wealth managers and asset managers, it becomes sort of a no-brainer to start looking at the DeFi space.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your insights, Amber.
Thank you.